So they were quite crucial in the General Assembly.
South Africa was in an adversarial position towards the UN right from the outset. Somebody should one day count them, but it must run into thousands of resolutions that were made on South Africa.
There was no mood for compromises. So there was anger, you know, there was real anger among the African group, among the Africans, and supported by the Friends of Africa.
A bitter debate raged at the United Nations. The issue, the projected boycott of the Republic of South Africa.
The representatives of Ghana, Morocco, and Philippines calls upon all states to boycott all South African goods and to refrain from exporting to South Africa strategic materials of direct military impact.
The news of the massacre stunned and shocked us and angered us greatly. It was something we could least have expected after the experience of Sharpeville. 1976 caught us unprepared. We were still building up on mass mobilization and building up on our armed struggle. But we found ourselves unable to respond to this brutality. After that, the struggle was at a new level, and we had to quickly adjust to that new level.
The arrest of Nelson Mandela, Walter Sisulu, and others earlier in South Africa was tormenting Owoar Tambo in exile. He was in exile, yes, but still a free man. Now he was obsessed with two things: to see his comrades freed, and possibly, in his lifetime, democracy in his country.
I had no doubt in my mind that the death penalty
of the two men involved in the Coffin Assault case, Theo Jackson and Willem Oosthuizen, the men who forced victim Lovejoy into a coffin, will spend 11 years and 14 years respectively behind bars. Priscilla Jana from the Human Rights Commission says the Middelburg Magistrate Court was warranted as a gross violation of human rights was committed. She also commended the court for dismissing Oosthuizen and Jackson's bid for bail. Jana says the case will set a good precedent.
We are of the opinion that this is a very serious case, and in fact, I think you can say safely that this emphasizes the need for the hate crime law that is in Parliament at the moment, the bill. You know, our country is still inundated with problems of racism and inequality, even after 24 years of freedom. And this is not to be accepted. It's really a very sad state of affairs.
And finally, Limpopo police have rearrested one of the prisoners who escaped from the Kutamas in Tumole Correctional Center in Toyando. Authorities have revised the number of escaped inmates from 6 to 9 and are still collating information on what sentence they were serving. It's understood the prisoners went on a rampage, damaging property by setting buildings alight. Here's police spokesperson Mutlafela Mujabin.
So the number now is 9. One was rearrested.